Good evening, students. In the previous classes, we have learned about the various sorting algorithms like insertion sort, bubble sort, selection sort, and so on. In today's class, we will be learning about quicksort algorithm. Now, quicksort algorithm, merge sort algorithm, these are the two algorithms which are included in your syllabus. Now, we have noticed that all the previous algorithms, it comprises of one single algorithm or one single procedure which we implemented in C program. Now, from quicksort and merge sort algorithms, these algorithms consist of two sections. That means that our algorithm will be executed in two different sections. One section will be considered as the quicksort algorithm, which will be interested or concentrated in sorting the array, and the second section will be concentrated upon the partition algorithm. What we do is, given any array, we partition the algorithm into several subarrays and we quicksort those subarrays, and at the end we combine the result and return a sorted array. Now, what we have learned is quicksort algorithm comprises of two sections. One section is the quicksort section and another section is the partition section. So, one section is the quicksort and another section is the partition section. Suppose an array will be given to us and we will apply this partition algorithm on that array over and over again, such that at the end only one element is left. And since we know that a single element is already a sorted element, so we will combine the single elements and we will arrive at the sorted array. So suppose this is our array. At 0th index 7 is present, at 1st index 1 is present, at 2nd index 3 is present, at 3rd index 5, 4, 2, 5, 6 and 6, 4. Now, in this array, we need to choose any element such that we will call that element as the pivot element. We can choose any element as the pivot element, but by traditional, and it is seen that if we choose always the last element of the array as the pivot element, our algorithm will be convenient for us to implement. So here we choose element at the last index, that is element 4, to be our pivot element. The aim of partition algorithm is to put this pivot element into its correct position. So, the aim of partition algorithm is to put the pivot element in its correct position. What do you mean by correct position? By correct position, I mean that the element 4 should be placed in the array in such a location such that all elements which are lesser than 4, that is 1, 3, 2, should be on the left hand side, and all elements which are greater than 4, that is 7, 5 and 6, should be on the right hand side. So, this position of the pivot element we term is at PI, that is the pivot index. So the main aim of partition is to put the pivot element into its correct location, that is the pivot index location, such that all elements which are lesser than 4 in the array should be on the left hand side, which we known as at the left subarray, and all elements which are greater than the 4 should be on the right hand side, which is known as the right subarray. Now, in this left subarray, we will again apply the partition algorithm, and in this right subarray, we will again apply the partition algorithm. So, this partition algorithm will be again applied on all the elements so that all the elements are at the end in its correct position. Now, in the main array, when we have applied the partition algorithm and put 4 in its correct position, this is the left subarray and this is the right subarray. Now, as I have said that we will again apply the partition algorithm on the left subarray. So, in the left subarray, we have these three numbers 1, 3 and 2.
Now, since I have said that I will be choosing always the last element at the last index as the pivot element, so here we choose the pivot element to be as 2. Now, if we apply the partition algorithm on this subarray, considering 2 is the pivot element, then we will get an array such that all elements to the left of 2 should be lesser than 2 and all elements to the right of 2 should be greater than 2. So, our new array is like this, right? So, if we consider that 2 is at the right pivot index location, then this is the left subarray of 2 and this is the right subarray of 2. Now, since the left subarray of 2, there is only a single element, so we will always consider that single elements are always sorted elements. So, 1 is in correct position. Similarly, if we consider this to be the right subarray of 2, then 3 is the single element, so 3 is also sorted and in correct position. So, 3 is in correct position. So, at the end of this stage, it is seen that the left subarray of 4 is already sorted and all the elements in the left subarray of 4 are in correct position. So, the output of left subarray of 4 is 1, 2 and 3. Now, we have seen that the left subarray of this in pivot element 4 is at the end sorted and the sorted list is 1, 2 and 3. Now, we are interested in sorting the right subarray of this pivot element 4. So, the right subarray is something like 7, 5 and 6. Similarly, we will choose the last element, that is element 6, as the pivot element. Now, since we have chosen 6 as the pivot element, we will be partitioning this algorithm in such a manner such that all elements lesser than 6 will be on the left side and all elements higher than 6 will be on the right hand side. So, now this is the position of our algorithm. Now, if we see the left subarray of this pivot element 6, then it consists of 5, which is a single element, and so it is sorted. Now, if we see the right subarray of this pivot element, that is 7, 7 is also a single element and sorted. So, the output of this right subarray of the previous pivot index element 4 is 5, 6 and 7. So, from the right subarray we get this sorted order 5, 6 and 7, and from the left subarray we have got this sorted order 1, 2 and 3. So, if we combine these two, here it will be 1, 2 and 3, then 4, and here will be 5, 6 and 7. So, at the end of applying this partitioning algorithm 3 times, we will be having one sorted array which will be like this 1, 2, 3, then 4, then 5, 6 and 7. So, now that we have learned about the quick sort mechanism, we will be writing the pseudocode of the quick sort. Now, if we have noticed carefully that 4 element we are representing or we are indicating this element as the pivot element and this location we are indicating at the pivot index or PI. So, when on the first stage we have positioned 4 in this location and we have this subarray, left subarray and this part as the right subarray, then in the next stage when we will give input for again quick sorting of this part of the subarray, then we are only interested in this position, that is from start till PI minus 1 location, because since this is the PI location and since PI location contains the right pivot index at the right location, then when we again want to apply this quicksort on the left part, we will be applying from start of the array till PI minus 1. And again, when we want to apply this algorithm on the left part, we will be applying this algorithm from pi plus 1 till end of the array. So, since we have seen that when we have a single element, we say that the array or the element is already sorted and we are returning those elements. So, our quicksort pseudocode stands something like this. In the quicksort function, we are passing the array, the start index of the array and the end index of the array. Now, if at any position it is seen that the array dot length equal to 1, that means in the array only a single element is left, then we are returning the element. Else, we are returning the pivot index of the pivot element through partitioning algorithm, and this partitioning algorithm is applied to the array, which is the starting index till the end index. Now, when we apply this partition algorithm over the array, then we again get a left subarray and the right subarray, then again we will applying the quicksort algorithm on the left part and right part. So here, after the partition statement, again there is a quicksort statement which comprises that the quicksort function will be applied in the left subpart, that is from start to PI minus 1, and again the quicksort algorithm will be applied on the right part, that is PI plus 1 to end. So this is the pseudocode for quicksort algorithm.